Welcome to this week about the water system. Before I give an overview of the content of this week, let's first have a look at what we mean by the urban water system. So what is the urban water system and what does it look like? We have already discussed the water chain as we focused on two types of urban water, drinking water and wastewater. However, urban water management is about five types of urban water. Surface water, groundwater. This is water that we generally do not see since it is in the subsurface. It can be fresh, indicated here in blue, or salt, indicated here in brown. Drinking water, which is produced from either surface water or groundwater. Wastewater and stormwater. These five types of urban water together form the urban water cycle. This water we will focus on the part of the urban water cycle indicated here by the purple arrows. The so-called urban water system, which consists of groundwater, surface water and stormwater. We will discuss how citizens and other stakeholders can be involved in co-creating urban water systems to guarantee a safe and healthy living environment. Therefore, both water quantity and water quality issues in the urban water system will be addressed. Let's now have a look at this week's setup. We start this week in Amsterdam, where we discuss the actors involved in urban water management and which roles and responsibilities they have. From Amsterdam's water company, Waternet, we will hear about one of the main challenges that our water managers are facing in Amsterdam, making the city rain-proof. Then we will focus on two aspects of urban water management where co-creation has an important contribution. First, we dive into the world of innovative measurement methods. We will see how citizens help sensing their city in various ways. We will hear that they have contributed to urban rainfall monitoring, mapping water nuisance, and assessing the quality of surface water in the city of Amsterdam. Second, we turn to the aspect of reconfiguring and maintaining the water system. In this part of the week, we will deal with the following questions: which stakeholders to involve, when to involve them, and how. We will illustrate this using three cases where citizens play a key role in the planning, design, and maintenance of the urban water system. Subsequently, we will change the societal context as we shift our focus from Amsterdam to China. We will see that in China, urban water problems are a growing concern and require new forms of management to come to solutions. So, first we discuss the current water management system in China and the challenges faced. And after that, you will be introduced into the world of Sponge City, a concept that is being implemented to tackle these challenges. And finally, we will share examples from various Chinese cities that illustrate how the Sponge City concept is being implemented in interaction with various stakeholders. And at the end of the week, we reflect and compare influences of the Western European and Chinese context on the urban water problems experienced and the solutions chosen. I will indicate the co-creation spectrum that we have seen throughout the week, and we will reflect on how and to what extent various stakeholders have been involved in the co-creation processes that we were presented. So, with this video, you know now what we mean by the urban water system and what you can expect this week, which is the final week dealing with water.